regreso aquí en Auto 060 en Cristina Radio Network. Esta semana tuvimos la oportunidad de ir a Boston para probar el nuevo Infiniti Q50. El nuevo auto, el primer auto que sale de la Infiniti con esta nueva nomenclatura, nuestra nueva orden de nombres y números de, para sus modelos. Así que vamos a hablar, estuvimos allá con Brett Brooks, Senior Product Planning de Infiniti. Y cuando escuchen hablar el nombre Johan en la entrevista, él se refiere a Johan The Nation, el nuevo CEO de Infiniti que vino de la Audi para cambiarle toda la imagen y toda la... el modo de pensar y de operar de la Infiniti, la nueva marca de lujo que antes era o es todavía en parte la división de lujo de la Nissan. Así que vamos a escuchar la entrevista con Brett Brooks, Senior Product Planning de Infiniti. So Brett, thank you for the opportunity of the first drive of the new Q50, which is marks the new beginning for Infiniti, right? In many ways.
Yes, it's true. You know, we set out from the beginning within the vehicle line team to create a vehicle that would really take it up to another level compared to our already highly successful G sedan. Even so, we wanted to create even a more premium, more refined, more sophisticated experience for our owners, and at the same time maintain our sporty heritage. That initiative, that goal has dovetailed and married completely with now Johan's vision for the entire Infiniti brand, which is to make us one of the premium automakers in the world.
Yeah, so if we track back a little bit, like the new beginning, you got Johan, the new CEO for Infiniti, the move to Hong Kong, the new headquarters there, the new nomenclature for the car. So this is, as I said, the beginning of that new era, right? It's been like, what, a year more or less or something? All those changes started to come
yes,
into place?
Yes, that's right. Johan joined us a year ago. And the company has since been organized as Infiniti Motor Limited, as a separate company now with global headquarters in Hong Kong. So we're no longer a subsidiary of some other, you know, big automaker or something like this, but we are our own standalone entity with our own profit and loss statement and so on. We have now quite a bit more autonomy within the company and decision-making capability in terms of the new products that we're developing, how we will expend our monies and so on in developing.
Yeah, which came into place in the development of this car, as I understand, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, within the vehicle team prior to Johan's arrival, there, you know, already was this goal to create a vehicle that was a complete step up. But with Johan's arrival, I mean, he's helped us in so many ways. In particular, I'll share with you that a few months back, earlier in the development cycle, there was a concern about some of the exterior stampings on the vehicle, which in an earlier phase of the company, prior to Johan's arrival, might have been something that we would have had to live with and just gone forward into production and into the market. But Johan's leadership was really, guys, look, if this is something that we need to fix, then we're going to double down and we're going to do this. And we had to make even, you know, die changes, this kind of thing that normally would be unimaginable. We've done it. And that shows, I think, his commitment, his dedication to making sure that the craftsmanship, the execution of this vehicle is at the premium level.
Yes. So yeah, we drove for a couple hours already, and it's really the sport part of it is fantastic. I really still
thank you.
Enjoyed with the paddle shifters here. The engine is a V6, 3.7, 326 horsepower?
328 horsepower,
28 horsepower,
yep.
Which you can really, really feel. Yep, and then there's a hybrid, right? The hybrid bridge.
Correct, yep. So in the this vehicle line, we're offering now an additional upgrade powertrain beyond the 3.7 liter, which is actually an HEV. It's a 3.5 liter. Engine coupled to a electric motor. The combined output of those is 360 horsepower, upgrade from the 328 in the standard V6. And beyond just the increase in performance, though, there basically is no trade-off for our customer. You get, in terms of highway mileage, an upgrade from 30 mpg, which is where the base powertrain is, to 36 mpg. In the HEV, so you know, significant increase in fuel economy, but also significant increase in performance.
Yeah, and this is curious because it's a hybrid, not with much emphasis in mileage, gas
yes.
mileage, but like performance, as you
exactly.
said, more horsepower and all that, which is yeah. a very interesting concept.
Yeah. yeah, yeah.
And unfortunately, we don't have a lot of time here on the radio to explain all the technology in this car, but like two main things are the new steering system and yeah. the new lane departure features, right?
Yeah, maybe if I can squeeze in three things, I'll try. Yeah. So the first one, yes, you're right. Direct adaptive steering is a world's first technology available on this vehicle, using a completely electronic feedback loop from the road to the steering wheel, as opposed to some kind of a yeah. hard mechanical connection. Allows us to do all kinds of things in terms of providing a wide range of tunings that the driver can customize on their own in terms of both steering effort and steering ratio. Also allows us to insulate the driver from unwanted feedback from the road, what we call kind of dirty noise yeah. or nibble harshness, these kinds of things. Yet on the other hand, it provides by an electronic means a completely connected to the road.
Yeah, and you can really feel it. I mean, I really experienced it. You can feel the difference with the normal setting and all that. Mm-hmm. So the other one is like lane departure.
Yes. So as an additional augmentation or adaption that's enabled by direct adaptive steering, we have active lane control. So it goes beyond a conventional lane departure prevention system, which are available on some other cars in the market right now. Not a widely available feature, but it's been available now for a couple of years. Active lane control goes even one step further, that rather than just using the brakes of the vehicle to cause a kind of abrupt yawing of the car back into the lane as you start to depart, because we have control over the steering system now via direct adaptive steering, we can literally just steer the car okay. in the center of the lane and provide that kind of assistance to the driver. So it pulls off the whole lane centering idea with a lot more finesse than other systems have in the
yeah.
past.
Yeah, and the third one?
The third one I just wanted to mention is our new IT system in the vehicle that we've are just barely rolling out. All new IT system that will be used in many Infiniti vehicles, now first available in the Infiniti Q50. It's a twin screen display when your listeners are able to see images of it and so on. They'll recognize right in the center console. Yeah. It's occupying a central location in the vehicle. It uses a touch screen interface, but we've also kept redundant controls so that anyone can get in the car and immediately drive it. Redundant hard switches, yeah. I mean.
A lot of features in that one, and a cool thing that is coming up next is like the capability of using apps
right.
through the driver's phone, right?
Absolutely, yes. So the system and its architecture is intended to be continuously upgradable and updated throughout the ownership experience in the car. So we aren't just kind of launching one system, throwing it out in the market, and then within 6 months or a year, it's already updated.
Which is what happens with technology. I mean, you download an app, and then like it's a new version. So like you're gonna be doing this, like when you use right. it in your iPhone, for example.
Exactly.
You get an alert, and you just get the update.
Exactly. So most of the updates for new applications and so on will be able to be done actually over the air, because we don't know 1 year from now what the next new popular app will be. But we can develop that interface on our side and make that available to our customer, and then he can download it and add it to his car as it becomes available.
Another exciting news that I heard this morning during the presentation of the new Q50 is that through your relationship with the Red Bull, some guy from that team is part of your team too.
Yes. So you might have heard of Sebastian Vettel, F1 champion.
Three-time champion.
Yeah, absolutely. He now actually has become part of the Infiniti team and works not only full-time as a F1 driver, but also now is director of performance within Infiniti.
Which, like doing real work. I heard that he's already like tested the new car that is coming up after this one.
Yes, he was involved in the final drives and final sign-off for this vehicle and provided feedback to the engineers as we were completing the product development for this car for the Q50.
Yeah.
And as we mentioned a little bit earlier this morning, we're bringing a new premium compact to the market that we'll unveil shortly in an upcoming auto show. And he's also been involved in the development of that car and in the tuning of that car.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for your time and the opportunity to drive in this new car. And maybe you can set up a weekend drive with Beto one time.
Yes, I will join you on that. Okay. Sounds wonderful. Okay, thank you very much.
Ahí teníamos a Brett Brooks, gerente de producción de autos de Infiniti, hablando sobre el nuevo Q50 Y este, como decía, el primer modelo que sale con la nueva nomenclatura específica de Infiniti, Q para sedanes, QX para crossovers y SUVs. E Infiniti tiene grandes planes para los próximos 5 años. Planean ampliar su línea de modelos de 60% dentro de los próximos 5 años. Y el siguiente modelo es un sedán de lujo compacto, o sea, por debajo de este Q50 que acaba de debutar aquí en Estados Unidos. Ha salido ya al mercado, está a la venta y empieza con unos precios bastante atractivos a partir de los 36.450 para el sedán, digamos el básico. El de motor de gasolina llega a los 44.750 y cuando se pasa al híbrido empieza a partir de $47,700 hasta llegar alrededor de los $50,000 con todo el equipo disponible que ofrece Infiniti para este nuevo modelo, el Q50 2014. Y como decíamos, ya este es un modelo que es candidato al premio del auto de Norteamérica para el 2014. Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos aquí en Auto 060, el peligro que tienen las personas de la tercera edad cuando se ponen al volante. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota.